I'm here to talk you through some of the things you can expect to see during your first week here and to help you get started down this new and exciting career path. Now, I want you to forget anything you may have heard about the old locations, you know. Some people still have a somewhat negative impression of the company. That old restaurant was kind of left to rot for quite a while, but I want to reassure you, Factor Entertainment is committed to family fun and above all, safety. They've spent a small fortune on these new animatronics. Facial recognition, advanced mobility, they even let them walk around during the day. Isn't that neat? But most importantly, they're all tied into some kind of criminal database so they can detect a predator a mile away. Heck, we should be paying them to guard you. Now that being said, no new system is without its kinks. You're only the second guard to work at that location. The first guy finished his week, but complained about conditions. We switched him over to day shift. So, hey, lucky you, right? Mainly he expressed concern that certain characters seemed to move around at night, and even attempted to get into his office. Now, from what we know, that should be impossible. That restaurant should be the safest place on Earth. So while our engineers don't really have an explanation for this, the working theory is that the robots were never given a proper night mode. So when it gets quiet, they think they're in the wrong room. So then they go try to find where the people are, and in this case, that's your office. So our temporary solution is this. There's a music box over by the prize counter, and it's rigged to be wound up remotely. So just every once in a while, switch over to the prize counter video feed and wind it up for a few seconds. It doesn't seem to affect all of the animatronics, but it does affect one of them. And as for the rest of them, we have an even easier solution. You see, there may be a minor glitch in the system, something about robots thinking he was an endoskeleton without his costume on, and wanting to stuff him in the suit. So hey, we've given you an empty Freddy Fazbear head. Problem solved. You can put it on anytime and leave it on for as long as you want. Eventually, anything that wandered in will wander back out. Something else worth mentioning, kind of the quirky modern design of the building. You may have noticed there are no doors for you to close. But hey, you have lights, and even though your flashlight can run out of power, the building cannot. So don't worry about the place going up. Well, I think that's it. You should be golden. Check the lights, put on the Freddy head if you need to. Keep the music box wound up. Piece of cake. Have a good night, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Thank you.
no! It closed the game. Oh, damn. Guys, what just happened? It closed the game. I'll explain to you guys
when I get back.
Okay guys, I'll tell you what happened. So what happened was, I picked it up. I can't believe I fucked it up. I can't believe I did that. Let me just zoom in the camera away. Once again, zoom in all the way. See what I'm doing. Yeah, I can't believe I fucked it up. I don't know how I fucked it up, I just did it. I'd say the challenges of Space Freddy's would be, the second game is very challenging. Sister Location is one of the challenging games. Don't play Sister Location, cause my old gameplay of it, that is just freaking weird. Cause, I didn't know. Sister Freddy's 2 is challenging too. I kind of juke this button until I hit my home on my phone. But anyway, hope you guys enjoy it. And as always.
Thank you.